Biff's Gaming Videos. Joysticks and joypads.
Trackballs and mouse pads.
Swimmers and my guns.
Fun.
Alien invasions.
Robotic invasions.
Dungeons and dragons.
Fun.
Home runs and touchdowns.
Jungles and ghost towns.
Videos from this sun.
Fun.
As America was thoroughly engaged in the Second World War, Nolan Key Bushnell was growing up in the northern Utah town of Clearfield. Population, 995. As remote as northern Utah was to the rest of the world, no one could have predicted that this little tyke would go on to start a worldwide revolution of his own. In high school, he worked at the Lagoon Amusement Park, where customers played midweek arcade games to win prizes. In his college years at the University of Utah, Nolan himself played the game of Space War, one of the very first video games ever designed on the school's mainframe computer. After college, Nolan and friend Ted Dabney joined forces to bring that game he played so many times in the college to the masses. First, they formed a company called Syzygy, then copied the game Space War over, renamed it to Computer Space, added a coin slot, and then signed a deal with Netting Associates to release it into pinball halls for Thanksgiving 1971. Even though Stanford University's Galaxy game preceded this by 2 months, Computer Space was the world's first mass-produced arcade video game ever. Unfortunately, it bombed. Deciding to start anew, they incorporated a new little company called Atari. After Bushnell attended a demonstration of the Magnavox Odyssey, Atari decided to do their own version of this game. They copied it, made improvements, and released it as Atari Pong. Thus, the onset of the modern video game era had begun. Eventually, Bushnell sold Atari to Warner Communications to finance the release of the Atari 2600 VCS in 1977. The following year, he left Atari. As part of the deal to sell Atari, Bushnell received a small pizza place that Atari owned and had invested in animatronics characters that could sing and dance. This was Pizza Time Theater, or Chuck E. Cheese. Bushnell took this little one-store national. In just a few short years, he managed to create two multi-billion dollar a year companies. He then formed the Catalyst Group, which invested in emergent technologies. This included personal robots, kiosks that reprogrammed video game cartridges, and was the first company to digitize the maps of the world for use in car navigation. After the video game crash in 1983, Bushnell sold off some of his holdings, including a subsidiary of Pizza Time Theater called Cadabrascope, to none other than George Lucas. This animation studio became yet another multi-billion dollar a year company, as it was later renamed to Pixar. Over the years, Nolan Bushnell has been involved in many companies and even rejoined Atari as a board member in 2010. It is not often a visionary emerges at the right time, at the right place, to influence so many lives. It is due to his imagination, hard work, and dedication that makes many of today's gadgets seem ordinary. So, I am pleased to introduce the recipient of the 2012 Video Game and Computer Hall of Fame, Most Influential People of the Video Game Era, Nolan Bushnell.